Well, let's see what's behind the final dead room. Wow. It's a pleasant looking place.
I see. So this is the final dead room. Feels a little eerie. Hope I don't get scared. Did the door just lock? I see. The door is designed to automatically lock.
It's not I would've.
It's not like I would've turned back if they stayed unlocked.
Oh!
I thought the door finally opened, now it's locked again. I figured you'd turn up since I haven't seen you in a while, but I never expected to see you here. Nagito? And why are you in such a dangerous place? Same to you, why are you here?
I
heard the body discovery announcement, I thought something happened in this room. And you got locked in when you came inside? You're a fool from head to toe. I'm truly ashamed. Well, not that I care. Just make sure you don't get in my way. Get in your way? The life-threatening game is going to start soon, right? It'd be annoying if you got in my way.
Could it be?
Are you planning to do it? Well, if I don't, I can't get out of here, right? Besides, the only way trash like me can be useful is by risking my life for everyone's sake.
That's wrong!
You're wrong. Nagito is not trash at all. There's no such thing as a human being who doesn't deserve to live. I know I'm being heartwarming right now, but my heart is super scared and pounding like crazy. Are you sure you're not just excited? You know, isn't it exciting to think that I can finally be useful for the sake of those who shoulder hope? Now then, about this so-called life-threatening game.
Alrighty!
If there's anything you don't get, just ask me. By all means, I'll help you make sure you get out of here.
Leave it to me!
Bring it on, escape game. It sounds like something a teacher would say. I shouldn't expect too much from her.
Damn, chat pretty much all but died off.
Iron bars are completely locking the door. As long as you don't do something about these bars, you won't be able to escape from this room.
For those of you who have no interest in playing an escape game, I prepared a shortcut. What would you like to do? Would you like to take a shortcut and bypass the inner game's rule? Oh no, we'll poke around a bit. It's nice that that's an option, though. Oh god, I feel like I have such a narrow field of view. It's Monokuma's plushie. Well, how about that?
You want me to punish you guys?
Looks like this plushie talks when you squeeze the tummy.
Thrills, chills, kills!
Ooh.
What did that say up above? Watch the views?
Point and click escape game Zero's favorite. For sure I have to input a 4-digit password.
No problem!
Secret plan, if you input 9999 password combinations...
Oh, 9999 password combinations will eventually open.
I'll leave the mindless work to you, Monami. I'll decline as well. Master to open this, I have a feeling that hint is close by.
Well, I'll poke around at this, but I gotta be honest, I have no interest in doing this. Television looks broken. Fires, huh? This might be useful for something, so I should grab it. Looks like some kind of password. And the rest password. SM something S. What?
I got it!
Setters of the days of the week, probably the password. It's that simple.
Big old bloody six on the wall. Something written in blood on the wall. It's number six.
Blood symbols alone don't make sense, but maybe if I combine them with something else.
We got a six, we got a three. Seven. God, is that meant to be an end? Alright, it says watch the news. It's just a very terrible end. Mecha curse just by looking at it. Hey, animal. Funhouse is okay. Kind of makes my fucking eyes bleed to be in there. Oh, is that actually a 5 and not actually a... attention to what I just said. I think my logic would better. Yeah, but I just love hearing the hint. Yeah, what's your suggestion, Prats? I seriously do not care about fucking doing this. Like, this has no interest to me whatsoever. Hey, Omega Zero, how you been, man? Well, we have some rewards. Bye, Omega Zero. Yeah, it looks like that might be a 4. Oh, is that a compass? You think it's 4, 3, 6, 7? Yeah, there's a compass. Northeast, west, south. So the question is, how does that tie to a number? I mean, I found the thing with numbers on it over here, but no real information. Actually, I haven't finished looking over here. Laptop. Looks like it's on, but it's locked, so I can't really access it. Okay, so I can't do anything with that, apparently. Assuming that's the door we came in through. Well, no, it isn't. There's a 5 in here. Oh, man. I wonder... Yeah, so I was trying to figure out is what way is north? Because there's numbers all over a bunch of the walls. But they don't have any specific bearing. What the hell is that? Okay, so that's the door. So we have a fucking closet. Backseating's off for this. Like I said, I really don't give a fuck about actually doing this. This has no interest to me whatsoever. Alright, so if we assume that north then is here. As you could argue, it's 3, 6, I guess 5. Three, six, five, seven.
Leave it to me.
Oops. In the wrong direction? No, it should have been north, east, west, south. I think it's upside down. Oh, yeah, okay. I see what you meant about the line. So, 3, 9. 3957. I find with shit like this when I'm actually playing like 9 hours, 9 person, 9 doors, but I'm not fucking playing that right now, so I kinda don't really wanna be. Well, we have a camera with no batteries. And a USB for a locked laptop. Well, let's see if it'll unlock it for us. Or not. Okay, so how do I use it on the laptop? Says I can use it to unlock the laptop, so how the fuck do I use it to unlock the laptop? Oh, I can't use it while I'm over there. The hanger... Oh, was there a hanger in the closet, you mean? Yeah, we can try. Let's see, can we get that? I think it'll just give us the number behind it, though. Nope. Oh, one hanger. Nah, Square just brings up our usual menu stuff. There is no click drag. Clicking out immediately causes it to pop that up. I can't use anything on anything else. Please tell me this is not the interface, because that... Okay, good. I was going to say, because that's terrible. Circle does nothing. Triangle does nothing either. Yeah. Can't use anything on anything else in my inventory. Let's see if Start will give me a list of controls. Okay, we have set item. There we go. First letters in the days of the week. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, meaning it's MTWTFSS. That is that simple. No, at least we know how to use shit. Can we... There we go. Now, let's actually take a look back here. Okay, no, I guess that's just the way in. God, I keep wanting to actually move forward to, like, look more closely at things, but you can't actually move from this spot. Let's see if we can work you over. Huh, well, I guess not. Reaching something under the bed, maybe? Well, it gets us into the desk, just not in the way we thought. Hmm? You use these to cut the iron bars. Best scissors ever? I'm joking, right? Isn't this supposed to be an indirect hint?
I'm sorry!
Hmm. No, we have scissors. I feel like I should be picking this up, but apparently not. Wire on the TV. Let's see if we can use it for reception. Okay, it doesn't seem so. Cut up the Monokuma plush. Ooh, let's get the fucking thing. Why not? Oops. Talking might be powered by a battery.
Enough already!
I didn't need any grannies, really. Alright, batteries in the camera. Sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn. So, S-M-V-E-M-J-S is our password. Oh god, now I actually have shit, now I can't see it. Get a fucking piece of paper, apparently. Oh, I have a piece of paper or a pencil, apparently. Damn it. Guess I can write on that if I can find a pencil. Where's my pencil gone? Oh, fuck it. I'll just write in one in the chat window so I can see it. Okay, there we go. I can understand why you forget about this part. It's pretty fucking forgettable. It's like, really, who cares? S-M-V-E-M. Is this Othello? Take a closer look at this.
All righties.
Yeah, there's no buttons. I mean, this lid back doesn't seem to open. It's this red light that's on top of the device. Lights on top of the unlocking device actually represent the number. Use a signal book on the laptop to decipher it. You know the number, how will you be able to input it? Only one thing in this room that can input a number into, right? Looks like I should put the number into that again. Let's take a closer look at this. No, I don't know what the numbers are, though. What'd you miss, Spoons? Were you around for Nekomaru's murder? This is impossible for your Keyblade. It's pretty fucking obtuse. Yeah, I seriously, I'm not interested in working through this.
Leave it to me!
Throw the code at Roxel. I'm not inclined to do this. Seriously, do not feel like screwing with it. I'd rather get on with the actual game. That's odd. Can't actually... Oh, because their text is there. Thank you. I hate wasting time on meaningless crap like this. Huh? No, we don't have a key, but... Unless that happens to fit. Doesn't look like it would, though. But apparently it does.
Ding, ding, ding.
Well, that's quite the ultimate option. Who cares about clearing it? Why does the exit feel like it's not opening? Hmm? What do you mean it won't open?
Ooh,
ultimate weapon indeed. Can I just tell you that?
That's...
Not just the exit, even the door we entered from isn't opening. Maybe the game isn't over yet.
Could it be?
Is there any chance that the thing I found earlier was just joking around? Seems like you have something on your mind. When I first arrived in this room, I received a letter.
I'm sorry!
I thought it was just a prank, so I didn't have a chance to tell you. Yes, it's this. Solve the mystery of the final dead room and you'll obtain the right to play the life-threatening game. Are you fucking kidding me? Oh my god. Alright, well, let's play goddamn Russian roulette. About the life-threatening game, it's life-threatening roulette. You're held reliable for setting the roulette's difficulty. Depending on difficulty, I prepared special prizes to make sure you don't overdo yourself. I see, so that's what it meant. What does it mean? Hey, Streamline Theory, yeah, been a while, how you been? It means the games up till now were just the opening act. From this point on is the real performance. Another truth bullet straight to the head. Life-threatening roulette. That's probably like Russian roulette. See, a gun came out from there. Which means I have to use that to play Russian roulette, right? Yeah, ultimate lucky student.
Hey!
Then allow me.
You can't!
No matter what, it's too dangerous. Hey, Monami, there's something I wanted to ask you. In all honesty, I don't really understand the rules of Russian roulette.
Hey!
If that's the case, load one bullet in the cylinder, then spin it. After that, point the gun towards you and pull the trigger.
You can't!
I'm expecting her to shoot him. Or him to shoot her instead. A nice streamline, that's excellent. Put bullets in all the chambers, everyone wins. Good old Dr. Cox. You can't do that, there's a 1 in 6 chance you'll die. A 1 in 6 chance of death. Which means the failure rate is only 1/6. Hey, is that rule really okay? I mean, if there's only a 1/6 chance of failing, wouldn't the game be too easy? So, shouldn't it be the opposite? Remove one bullet from the gun, and then use it while there's still 5 bullets loaded. If you do that, there'll be 1/6 chance of success. Yeah, that would definitely make it a more thrilling game.
That's...
What are you saying? Let's give it a go.
Hold on, Nagito! What are you doing?
Well, he's the ultimate lucky student.
What am I doing? Playing Russian roulette, obviously. I've only removed one bullet. So there's only a 1 in 6 chance that I'll survive.
You can't! Please stop!
It's not much of a talent, but even I have an ultimate level talent, you know? I'm the ultimate lucky student. But if I can't win when there's only a 1 in 6 chance of success, then what kind of ultimate talent is that? I mean, if my luck gets me killed like this, there's no way you can really call that talent. If I'm truly the ultimate lucky student,
I'm liking him right
now.
I
need to survive here. Isn't that right?
Please stop!
That was a... I was gonna say, that was a very soft click.
Oh, the sound just now. That was the door unlocking, right? Looks like we finally cleared the final dead room.
I'm scared of you, Nagito.
Huh? Really? Oh, well, let's go. The Octagon should be just beyond that door. This is the Octagon, huh? Holy shit. What a distorted room.
Well done!
Congratulations, Nagito.
Yeah!
Congratulations on clearing the final dead room.
He should have put in 6 if he was truly lucky the gun would have jammed. Yeah.
And you even challenged yourself with the highest difficulty with only a 1/6 chance of success.
Here!
I have a modest present for someone like you. Now then, this first.
Is this the Future Foundation's file?
Didn't we already get this when we were at the roller coaster?
Uh-huh.
I'll just think of it as an extension of that.
Yeah, this is still the second game, Quills. How do you ask?
Extension?
Hey!
What are you giving without permission? Let's see, one more special prize. There you go.
He just got all our profiles, didn't he?
This crest. Is this Hope's Peak Academy's? That's right, this file. It contains your student profiles from your time at Hope's Peak Academy. Meaning, they're profiles that you guys don't even remember.
Your time at Hope's Peak Academy, huh? After all this time, I still can't believe it.
Wah-wah?
You mean the matter concerning your stolen school memories? I mean, no good person like me actually spent time with everyone else-
Oh, that's Nagito. Oops. No good person like me actually spent time with everyone else at Hope's Peak Academy?
No, that's impossible. If that's true, how did I feel? Surely I would have spent my time feeling ashamed of myself for being in the presence of such greatness. Jeez, when you're upbeat or depressed, I still don't understand you at all.
Phew!
Oh well, anyway, I'm passing this along to you. How you use it is up to you. Thanks, I'll take a look at it later. So if I look at these profiles, I'll be able to find out what Hajime's hidden talent is too,
and before Hajime's profile is missing.
I'll probably be happy about it. Yay, someone like me was finally useful. What are you laughing about? Oh, I just thought it was ironic. Out of everyone here, someone like you was the one who obtained Hope's Peak Academy student profiles. Not sure if you're lucky or unlucky. What does that mean? Looks like things are gonna get interesting. Yes, Nagito, you might be the one who makes things much more interesting. I don't really know what you're talking about.
Hey!
What are you planning? What's written in there?
Like...
Anyway, Monami.
Hey!
No cheating. You haven't reached the end yet.
Hmm? Yeah!
And then you haven't played Russian Roulette yet. But Nagito already did it.
What are you saying?
No.
Damn it!
Get over here. Revenge of the final dead room.
No!
Jeez, they're gone. In the end, I still don't understand what Monokuma was talking about. But for now, I'll leave this file for later. First, I need to investigate this room. It's not like I know how to get out of here.
Well. Pick your weapon? Lot of shit in here.
Axes, swords, hammers, metal wires. A lot of items here that could be used as weapons. I don't see anything that looks like it could be the ultimate weapon. I wonder where that so-called ultimate weapon is. I see. So there are a lot of firearms here too. There are handguns and grenade launchers even. I don't see anything that looks like it could be the ultimate weapon. No, it's right there on the top shelf, man. I wonder where the so-called ultimate weapon is.
A window?
Why is there only one window at a place like this? Could there be some kind of hidden meaning to it? In actuality, what could it mean? In my mind, I entertained various possibilities as I walked slowly toward the window. And then, the moment I peeked out that window... Huh? This is... what I actually saw outside that window. It's completely different from any possibility I had in mind.
I'm guessing he finally got an idea of how these places actually attach.
I see, so that's what it was. I saw outside this window. If I start piecing it together and think about it. Yeah, I see. It seems I'm finally starting to get a larger perspective of the funhouse with this. Refrigerator? Here? I wasn't expecting to find drinks in it, but when I opened the door and peeked inside, I see there are poisons stored in here. You can secretly kill everyone with poison. In a way, it can be considered the most powerful weapon, except for the fact it'd be difficult to get the poison into anyone since there's no food to poison. And no drinks, really. In that case, you have to ignore the rules. Okay, it's just the one Ella. The one refrigerator thing. What are you? There's a door in the floor? Isn't this the first floor of Strawberry House? Can this door lead underground? Based on the sketch, there shouldn't have been a bunker. No, maybe what lies beyond this door. Things are finally getting interesting. Amazing. As expected of a place that cannot be reached unless you clear the final dead room. Thanks to how I arrived here, all the separate pieces seem to have connected together in one fell swoop. Chain reaction culminating in the truth, all thanks to just one clue. I know that now's not the time to enjoy things, but this is definitely a good feeling. Especially that window. That's right, everything became connected from here. Thanks to that window, I realized the mystery of the ultimate weapon and the funhouse. Now, all I have to do is tell everyone else about this. What if the ultimate weapon is information? It's knowledge. Before I do that, I should finally take a look at the file I received from Monokuma. Especially if it's everyone's student profiles from their time at Hopespeak Academy. That's important. Cautiously opened the file and read it carefully, taking care not to miss a single letter. Carefully. Huh? Hey. Hey, can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Huh? I'm sorry, did you say something?
Well?
It's been about 2 hours since you spoke to Fuyuhiko. I wonder if the elevator's been fixed yet. It'd be bad if we still split up before the class trial, so maybe we should call them one more time. Are you even listening? I only brought that up because I'm really worried. Sorry. So what are you gonna do? You're right, I'm worried about them too. Let's try calling Strawberry House one more time.
I think...
Anything still lines up with your Chiaki hypothesis? Oh, I suppose if one person was going to kill someone specifically in order so that we didn't starve to death, that might be her. I don't think it was a grudge, she simply killed the one thing that wasn't human. I don't know. We're not going to do the trial today though, so it won't matter. Well, well, well. Either the elevator's fixed, or somebody found something secret.
I need to plug this in, apparently.
Alright, there we go. Suddenly, Nagito.
Hello there.
Yep. Hello there, Hajime. Nagito, why are you here? Because I showed up. Showed up? How did you even come here? Maybe I teleported. Huh? Nagito's sudden appearance. Interesting. Hey, answer me seriously. How were you able to come to this side? What if they got here through the dead room?
Hey.
Before I do that, there's something I need to tell you guys. There is. Tried to investigate Strawberry House as much as I could.
Now then.
I'll give you those details first. Let's hurry this up. After being abruptly interrupted by Nagito, Chiaki and I learned about the results of his investigation of Strawberry House. Got the elevator, got the button. The Higo's account. The wall clock. Oh, I guess these were pretty important. Especially the fact that everyone in the Strawberry House heard that rumbling noise, too. But, what was that about the wall clock's alarm going off before that happened? Also, the fact that Strawberry Hall's button was broken is definitely worth noting.
Hey!
Also, there's one more thing I need to tell you guys. I've cleared the final dead room. Huh?
Could it be?
You did the life-threatening game?
Wow.
It wasn't life-threatening at all.
For me.
It was just a little escape game that ended with some Russian roulette.
Russian roulette?
It's a game where you load one bolt in a gun, spin the cylinder, point toward you, and pull the trigger. So you really did it.
Man.
Ah, so that's how you're supposed to play it. So it would've been fine if I'd only used one bullet, huh? I guess it was just as Monami said.
Huh?
Actually...
I misunderstood and thought that I had to take one bullet out of the cylinder, so that's how I did it. You only had a 1 in 6 chance of surviving.
Well...
I'm still alive. After all, the only good thing about me is how lucky I am.
Speculation, tiny hole behind painting the guy.
You never know. What's wrong with him? I knew he was strange from the start, but for him to casually do something so suicidal... He's crazy, that's all there is to it. Anyway, because I was able to clear the final dead room, I was able to obtain several rights. And one of those rights... was the freedom to move between Grape House and Strawberry House. Not only that, but whenever I move back and forth, I don't even need to play the game again.
Back and forth? Where would you even be able to do that, and how?
Man.
Hey, Hajime.
You stay quiet.
You've been repeating yourself over and over and it's bugging me. Could you let me speak freely for a change? Anyway, I'm definitely lucky. Thanks to that, I was able to clear the roulette at the highest difficulty. And I obtained quite an amazing prize as my reward. And that's... Is that the Future Foundation file?
Yep.
It's a continuation of the file we received at the roller coaster.
Continuation?
There's even more detailed information about the killing school life that was in the earlier file.
The killing school life?
I mean the killings that took place at Hope's Peak Academy, right? Hey, CTC, welcome back. As I recall, Yakio was one of the students who participated in it.
But even when we learn more about the killing school life, it has no relevance to us whatsoever. There was information about the order of the killings and who the killer was for each incident. That is extremely boring to read about the deaths of people I don't even know.
Right?
Besides Byakuya, of course.
It's just as I thought. That Byakuya was the Byakuya we knew, right?
But...
However, I can't say the information was completely useless. In truth, there are similarities between the killing school life and this killing school trip.
Similarities?
For example, the first murder involved someone important getting stabbed to death in an unexpected place.
Hey!
Second murder revealed the presence of a serial killer among the group. The third murder was actually two killings that happened in succession.
Hey!
What do you guys think about these strange similarities?
It's definitely strange.
Well...
Can't think of those as coincidences, especially if Monokuma's behind the motives in driving the murders. What are you trying to say?
Hey!
By the way, the fourth murder of the killing school life was apparently ruled a suicide. Huh? Whether that means something or not, it's something each person should think about on their own. I just wanted to tell you guys the truth.
The truth? Are you sure you're not just trying to confuse us?
Jeez!
Your complaints just never end, do they? You can talk like that. I won't want to tell you anymore. I even learned what your talent is, too.
Huh?
Well...
Now the file wasn't the only one I received from Monokuma. This is another one.
That seal.
Yep.
Indeed, it's the Hope's Peak Academy school crest.
Perhaps...
Does that have information about her stolen memories?
How unfortunate.
Unfortunately, I couldn't find any clues about that. This file doesn't contain our information, just Hajime's information.
Oh, so the total opposite of what I expected.
Just mine?
Why?
Isn't that weird? Why only Hajime's information?
Jeez.
It's quite troubling that you would ask me that. I must say, it was always interesting that Hajime was the only one who couldn't remember his talent.
Right?
And that ends now.
Are you serious? Did you really find out why I was chosen by Hope's Peak Academy?
Man.
In a way, it's just as Chiaki said. Hajime's existence is special. Because you were
not accepted into Hope's Peak Academy?
Just some reserve course student from the reserve department.
Huh?
Well...
Not like the primary department for main course students who possess ultimate talents. The reserve department is for reserve course students who enter the school through a basic entrance exam. Essentially, like a substitute or second string. Well, even then, that's just a name only. Reserve Department pretty much only exists to increase Hope Peak Academy's revenue stream. Reserve Department? Substitute? Second string? Revenue stream? What is he saying? Like I said, to be a Reserve Corps student, you don't need to possess an ultimate talent. You just have to pay a rather costly entrance fee and tuition. With the funds obtained from these exams, the Academy can focus on bolstering and researching talent. Through this, the symbols of hope can be raised.
Isn't that right?
Which means you're just a stepladder, and you should feel honored. An average, talentless human can be put to good use for those who are known as mankind's hope. What the hell does that mean? Perhaps you simply weren't determined enough. Did you admire hope? Are you willing to sacrifice your body and soul to attend Hope's Peak Academy? Or maybe, you're just obsessed with Hope's Peak Academy like a fangirl following the latest trend. It's not like that, I...
Stop it.
Wanted to become Hope? If that's what you're thinking, just stop it. Listen carefully. The only humans worthy of becoming Hope is this amazing talent and a strong will. And the moment you're born into this world, you either have that or you don't.
There's no mistake.
It has nothing to do with effort. It must be chosen by Hope to become Hope.
You don't even know?
That's why. It's not even worth admiring. Or, were you so blinded by your admiration for Hope's Peak Academy that you couldn't even see that? Oh boy. You're just some nobody from the Reserve Corps who never had a talent to begin with. Nobody who forgot he was a nobody. That's all. And I was just... That's right, you were never an ultimate. You had no talent whatsoever. I... have any talent? I'm just an ordinary high school student?
Man.
Oh, I feel sorry for you. Are you shocked to
That's
learn-
That's not it.
Damn it. Are you shocked to learn that you were the only one who didn't have a talent? Still, if you think about it positively, it looks like there's no more reason to doubt you. Now that we know who you are, a normal, average, utterly unremarkable high school student, there's no way you can be associated with the Future Foundation. But if it's not Hajime, who in the world could the traitor be? The survivor of the previous killing school life, Byakuya, would have been the most likely candidate. Now, that's probably impossible.
Hey!
Are you listening?
Hold it!
There's no need for you to listen to this.
What?
Well?
It may be important to talk about who the traitor is, but we need to focus on Nekomaru's murder first. Because if we can't survive the class trial, everyone's going to die together anyway.
Yeah, we just took a beating on that one.
In that case, would the traitor be among those killed as well? That's something I truly wonder about.
Yep.
Oh well, it's fine. I'll stop for now.
Hey.
You said you cleared the final dead room and obtained these files. That means you've gone to the Octagon, right?
Hey.
Are you curious about the ultimate weapon?
So...
Did you find out what it was? Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. Is there any reason I should answer that? Huh? What the hell? I'm the one who cleared that room, and I'm free to divulge any clues I obtained there as I see fit, right? Are you planning to keep it a secret? Are you planning to side with the killer again?
Man.
Like I said, I'm not on the killer's side. That hasn't changed since this began. How many times must I repeat myself? I just want hope to shine even brighter. What you're saying doesn't make any sense at all. Just tell us already. Tell us about the ultimate weapon.
Jeez.
I guess I have no choice. I suppose I can tell you one little tidbit. You're right. I did go to a place that seemed to be the Octagon, and I found many different weapons there. I didn't find anything worthy of the name Ultimate Weapon. Don't lie, there's no way that's possible.
Stop it.
Coming from someone with no talent like yourself, that's truly offensive. Wow, I think we've lost our fanboy. The crush is over. What did you say?
Oh.
Fine, I understand. Now's not the time for us to be fighting anyway. If you won't tell us, we gotta do it ourselves. Now, should we go back to investigating Mekamaru's case? You better hurry. The class trial is gonna start soon.
You're right.
I haven't even seen the crime scene. Also, the guys in Strawberry House should be coming over to the site any moment now.
Bye now.
Then, while we're at it, I'll go on ahead.
Hey.
Hajime. It's okay, I already know. I'm gonna focus on Nekomaru's case now, right? It's true that I'm shocked, but now's not the time for me to feel like that. Right now, I can't afford to be the only one who's depressed. I need to survive with everyone else and return home. That's what's most important. Isn't that right?
Yep.
I'm relieved to hear that. We should get moving then. Yeah, you're right. I should just forget about it for now.
Need to focus on Nekomaru's case. Just had a few interesting thoughts. Alright, let's see if we can get the last of the investigation stuff. Oh, Nagito is always holding something back. I've returned from the depths of hell. Gundam.
Yo.
Sorry we're late.
Hey.
Just so you know, it's all thanks to me. I'm the one who fixed the elevator. See, it's just as I said, right?
Hey!
Are you even listening to me? I'm trying to stand out here.
Hey.
More importantly, Kazuichi, did you look into that matter I asked you about?
Huh?
Oh, that thing about the compass? I looked into it while I was coming here, but I think this compass might be broken.
You stay quiet.
I didn't ask for opinion, just tell me the results. Well, the compass needle rotated 180 degrees while we were riding the elevator. Needle rotated 180 degrees?
Yep.
I see, it's just as I thought. Huh? Hey, what do you mean by that?
Well, that's obvious.
Well, obviously the elevator most likely rotated 180 degrees. Elevator rotated?
Now then.
I should go investigate Nekomaru's body. Remember, as if he were thumbing his nose at us, Nagito began making his way toward Grape Tower.
Oh my!
What the hell is wrong with him? Doesn't he seem pissed off or something? Nagito, what do you know? How much do you know? Alright, his account is just about the direction. I suppose we should probably actually just go back in. See if there's anything we need to double check. Yeah, there's a lot of salt going around right now.
You serious?
Nekomaru, are you serious?
Damn it!
I don't know who did this, but this is pretty fucked up.
Hey.
Now's not the time to get sentimental. Oh, we need to hurry up and investigate. We've already investigated everything we can.
Wow.
No, you haven't. There's still something you should be able to investigate more thoroughly. Now that Mikan is no longer with us, we can't perform an autopsy, but Kazuichi could.
Right?
Kazuichi should be able to disassemble the body, right?
Huh?
It cannot be!
Is that true? Are you gonna disassemble Nekomaru's body?
I won't forgive you!
Don't screw with me. Hasn't Coach Nekomaru been through enough already?
You don't know?
Been through enough? We need to perform this investigation so we can find out who the killer is. Man. I would rather have played as Soma. Actually, I think I said that during Danganronpa 1, too. I wanted to play as Bergami, not as Makoto. Oh, thank you for the host, Maximus. Much appreciated. Cheers. Or perhaps you don't want to know, Akane. Maybe you don't care about what happened to Nekomaru.
Damn it!
You stay quiet.
You suck at using your brain and you really want to know who the killer is. Try not to interfere so much.
Damn it.
Jeez.
Come on, Kazuichi. What are you standing there for? Damn it, fine. I just have to do it right. I know I said I wanted to see his insides, but not like this. This is just too much.
Well...
Going well, Maximus. How are things with you? Come on, you guys feeling okay too? Now's not the time to be staring into space. Nagito, there's definitely something wrong with you. Mother's just treating me differently ever since he found out I have no talent, but... seems like that's not entirely the case. Which one, Jake? His attitude toward everyone else is strange now, too. Why? Well, what do you got, Kazuichi?
Damn it!
It's your best Shark Week. I'm so far. There's no way I can get sentimental at a time like this. Oh, nice, Maximus. I don't have to worry about spoilers on my thumbnails on my follow page. I feel awful for Nekomaru, but this is necessary if we're going to find out the truth behind this case. As he forced out his voice through clenched teeth. Kazuichi faced Nekomaru, his eyes full of determination, and began stabbing his tool knife into Nekomaru's body. I did 9 hours, 9 persons, 9 doors, or whatever the ordering the name was. I have Virtue's Last Reward on the shelf, but I've never played it.
Huh?
Nagito gave it to me. He said he had it ready before we even went to the amusement park.
So Nagito did that too, huh? It's like Nagito has full control of the situation.
Maybe...
Looks like the damage to his head is the reason.
No, fortunately nothing was spoiled.
The reason Nekomaru died, I mean stopped functioning. His torso was covered in huge dents and his parts are dislocated. Maybe a gear shaft broke too? Well, for now I tried disassembling Nekomaru's chest. That should help us learn something, right? That's the case. I need to look at Nekomaru's body one more time.
No bugs in the game, just never sat down to play it.
Apparently Kazuichi has finished disassembling Nekomaru's body. We should probably check it out one more time. And there's the clock I've been waiting to check. Nekomaru's chest panel is open. Clock inside is completely exposed. Hands of the clock look like they're pointing to 7:30. Also looks like the clock's alarm was set for 7:30 a.m. Which means this clock broke the moment the alarm started ringing at 7:30 a.m. Well, 7:30 a.m. is strange, right? I mean, we should have arrived at Grave Tower just before 7 a.m. from Monokuma Tai Chi. Is this clock malfunctioning? No, wait. Yep, all the numbers were fucked with, like we said. Highly effective clock, or radio clock. Receives radio signals so it can automatically update fixed intervals, extremely accurate, and cannot be adjusted.
Yeah. We spent some time as Nagito, and it was very interesting. And we found out what Hajime's talent is. He's a reserve student. He has no fucking talent whatsoever. And that was after we played Russian Roulette with 5 bullets in the gun. Ultimate lucky student. Why does this broken clock say 7:30 a.m.? I love how early we called that clue. Okay, nothing of this is new. What's wrong with him? He's crouching over Nekomaru's body and it almost seems like he's glaring at him. Probably because Nekomaru might have committed, suicide.
You're the worst!
Huh?
Jeez.
You guys overlooked an important clue. I swear you're just the worst. As I thought, there's no way I can leave this to you guys. What are you talking about?
Well...
I found this under a fragment of the pillar that tipped over. Is this a doorknob?
You don't even know?
Looks like the screws came out with it. It wouldn't happen unless you applied a ton of force to it. Plus, it looks like there are scratches near the base of the doorknob.
Hey!
Don't you think it's strange?
See?
We examine the far back door in Grave Tower. The doorknob is still intact, right? Now that you mention it, you're right.
Now then.
If that's the case, where did this doorknob come from? If it's not the door that leads to Strawberry Hall, then there's only one other possibility. It'd have to be the door connected to Grape Hall that we entered from, right? The ultimate I have no talent, I'm boring. Ultimate talentless hack. We should try it out. Try it out how?
You don't know?
We take the elevator to Strawberry House, and we enter Strawberry Tower from Strawberry Hall. It's the only way we can see the other side of that door, right? The button to open the door in Strawberry Hall is broken, right?
It's obvious!
We can just repair it. After all, we have the ultimate mechanic on our side.
Well,
you're right, but I need parts to repair the door in Strawberry Hall. I can repair it if it's broken, but if I don't have enough parts, there's not much I can do about it. You have plenty of parts right here. Just. Scrounge through dead guy. He won't mind. He's not going anywhere.
See?
Just use Nekomaru. I'm sure if you dig through his body, you can find parts you can use. Hold on. You're saying we should use parts from our dead friend? It's called recycling. That's a much better alternative than disposing it with the rest of the junk, right? Junk?
Hey.
Kazuichi? Is it possible or impossible? Like you said, I could probably use these parts to repair that button, but... Seriously, hold on. Even if you do repair that button, what's gonna happen to the chain on the other side of the door?
Huh?
Chain? Door leads to Strawberry Hall has a chain wrapped around the doorknob. Even if you fix the button on the Strawberry Hall side, the door won't open as long as that chain is here. You don't need to worry about that at all. Huh? I don't need to worry? What does that mean?
Now then.
Kazuichi, we should go over to Strawberry Hall so you can repair the door. Hey, I'm not finished. Hajime, you're gonna come later too, right? It'd be really bothersome if you didn't. Maybe there's someone in the tower, the door won't open at all.
Right?
So you should at least make sure you're not pulling my leg. After tersely saying that, Nagato left the area.
Huh?
What the hell happened to him? He seems on edge about something. Who knows?
Damn right!
Now that reminds me. Nagato asked Kazuichi to do something weird for him, right?
Yep.
That's something to do with how the elevator spins 180 degrees. I wonder what it could mean.
Hey!
Actually, to tell you the truth, Nagato asked me to do something weird, too. Tell me to investigate all the clocks inside both buildings. That someone did. Clocks? So I did what he said and checked them all, but none of the clocks had their times messed up.
Jeez!
Why'd he ask me to do that in the first place? I don't get that bastard at all. For now, why don't we head over to Strawberry Tower, too? Yeah, he's basically just really, really pissy that Hajime's not an ultimate. It's like, I'm crushing on a dude with no talent? You have no hope. Along with the doorknob matter, there may still be many mysteries surrounding us that we don't understand. If we go to Strawberry Tower, we might be able to solve some of those mysteries. Maybe.
Jeez, you're pathetic.
I think that's all we can do. Let's head over. No, you're right. What Nagato said about the door opening. What is he planning to do about the chain? So, are we going to find out there's actually two towers? Curious how this is gonna work. That's interesting. It is a tower, right? I suspect we're correct in that they overlap. But I wonder if one building is much higher than the other one. I don't understand this at all. I guess let's take a trip. Thanks to Kazuichi, the elevator is working now. Alright, let's go. We walked into the elevator. We made our way to Strawberry House. Hey, you're here.
Hey, hey!
Kazuichi, how'd the repairs go? Yeah, well, the damage wasn't too bad once I got the parts, so I was able to fix it right away.
You!
You got a lot of nerves saying that when you use Negamora's parts without my permission.
Hey, hey!
Well, I mean, even so.
Now then!
Now that we're all here, why don't we hurry up and try it out? What will happen if you press the button to Strawberry Hall's door?
Even so.
There's no way it'll open. You haven't done anything about the chain.
Hey!
The door to Strawberry Hall behind Nekomaru's body was blocked off by the chain, remember? If you didn't do anything about that, it doesn't even matter if you fix the button on the outside. Oh, we'll know if we try it out.
You!
It's not even worth trying it out. No, we've all come this far. If he's saying we should try it out, then we should give it a shot.
Yep.
Yeah, that'd be great. So how many floors to the tower, I wonder? There's no way this door will open. All on the other side is chained up. Feeling a resignation, I press the button. Why did it open?
Impossible!
Where did the chain go?
Hold it!
Hold on a sec. That's not the only thing that's strange. That's right. There's no other way to say it. This definitely looks weird.
So...
What do you mean, huh?
Hey, hey!
Wait, doesn't this all look the same as when we were in Grape Tower? Yeah, you're right. When we were inside Grape Tower, Nekomaru's body was in front of the far back door. Welcome to rotation. Nekomaru's body was in front of the far back door. means his body should be in front of the door to Strawberry Hall. So if we enter from Strawberry Hall, his body should be in front of the door as we walk in. Why isn't it like that? Why is Nekomaru's body in front of the door to Grape Hall?
Hey!
Not just that, the parts that I carefully arranged when I disassembled the body all moved too. Body isn't the only thing that moved. Even the tipped over pillar and the spilled oil. They all moved the exact same way. The scene looks identical to how we saw when we entered from Grape Hall. Everything that was at the crime scene inside of Grape Tower shifted to the opposite side. As if it all rotated 180 degrees, right? Can't imagine that the floor actually rotated 180 degrees, but... is that really what this means? No, it's more than that. I feel like there's an even greater mystery here. I'd love to see an outside look at the funhouse. A mystery so great that it could drastically affect the outcome of the case. Might have to rethink this. I need to fundamentally rethink how we've been approaching this case.
I see.
Chain disappeared. A strange feeling I felt when I went back and forth between the two towers. Yeah, just as I thought, it was definitely the right choice to confirm this. This is you thought. You already knew about this mystery? You have a bad habit of relying on others when you don't understand. Why don't you try investigating first?
See?
The door at the far back with the picture of the grape on it. Maybe there's a clue hidden there. There's a clue on the door? Well, there's a missing handle. It's the door with the picture of grapes on it. It should lead to Grape Hall. Wait, huh? Well, the doorknobs is gone? It's like the screws came out with it.
Now then.
It's the same as the doorknob that was on the floor.
See?
The screws came out with it, right? And the doorknob next to Nekomaru's body came off the door to Grape Hall.
Well...
oh, that's what it looks like. You said clue, were you talking about this? What is it a clue to? Hey, we hit level 40.
What?
Did you get even more confused? No need to worry, just one clue will change everything. Huh? All the mysteries will be solved, as if everything were linked together if you can reach it. Just like I did. What does that mean? Even if I ask him that, Nagato probably won't give me an answer. So it'd just be a waste of time to ask. Oh, thank God.
It appears that it's time for the class trial!
And I'm gonna call it right there.